When you guys have Walker on the court, does it change the way that you are able to generate threes?
Yeah, obviously he's a big target down there in the block, and he's understanding that too, that he's a big target, so people are swarming him when he gets too close to the basket, and he's smart enough to make those reads, and he's getting better. He's gotten better of, like, just getting setting good screens, and he's getting people open that way as well, so definitely helps.
Will said one of the focuses for getting you more threes is in transition, hopefully. And
yeah.
Wondered if you, like, are you trying to be a wing three or corner three guy there, or are you trying to trail at that point, or what? Where are you trying to get those?
I'll give you my scouting report. just trying to find the opening. Really, it doesn't matter if it's, obviously we want to hunt corner threes as a team, and but whatever, wherever the opening is, just trying to run the court, and a lot of times it is corner, and we've done some flip game when I'm trailing the play, and just trying to have the variety of, those are the kind of, I feel like with the athleticism in today's game, just how many transition opportunities there are, like, it's a big part, because when teams get half-court defense set up, like, it's tough to play against that kind of physicality, and so just trying to hunt those in transition and stuff like that. So,
what did you like most about your half-court defense as a team tonight?
Well, where's the, I think we did a solid job.
You did.
Rebounding and trying to improve on that as always, but I think that's where Walker helps out a lot too. When he gets to guard perimeter, he's doing a great job on that. We can kind of fan out the shooters, and he's such a good rim protector that we're kind of living him playing ones with the guys, because he can catch up to them at the rim and eliminate their three-point attempts that way as well. So just trying, that's the emphasis, trying to get back on defense and transition. That's the hard part. And then obviously trying to get better at half court, but that's like the, we've been okay on that.
Do you like early starts?
Yeah, I do.
Well, why is that? And would you put, like, how is your day different, I guess, when you start at 3 o'clock versus 7?
I guess there's no nap, so it's more of a quicker start. But I just like the fact that it's over earlier. Get to go home and have dinner and hang out with your family a little bit more than on a normal game day, because you got shoot arounds and then you take a nap. Like, there's home games that I don't even see my family on that day, so I prefer to get done earlier and get the day's work done.
I was talking to Will before the game about the fact that your attempts at the rim are down this season, and the efficiency is down at the rim also, and I was kind of asking him what he thought the reason was, and he had mentioned how much you guys have been working on punishing the switch and kind of working, operating in a different area of the court, and that that's gonna sacrifice some of maybe your movement towards the rim on some plays because you're specifically working on different stuff. How do you view that?
That's part of it, for sure. Getting a little different kind of looks, but also recognizing the, when you put the ball down, how teams are helping and sending help side defense way earlier and making me make the read. And so I think that's part of it too, just trying to having to deal with the physicality and getting used to that, and kind of playing through that contact. And but I think it's, a lot of it is just decision making too. Like, when there is double teams, making, being able to make that pass out and making the right read, and then obviously the efficiency goes up when you're getting good looks at the rim instead of forced ones. And that what he was saying, it's kind of a new area of what you're working on. So kind of not worried about it. Just kind of come back to normal. So,
Lauri, Coach said he was proud of your overall tempo, the team's tempo overall throughout this game. You know, from a player perspective, you know, how do you feel about the flow of the game today?
Yeah, I feel like it was a fast-paced game. there was times they got a little tired with the way we were moving, changing ends on, well, both teams, offense and defense. And so it was a fast-paced game, and I think we, and when you're playing that way, there's teams going to make a run. So I think we handled their whatever 17-0 run they had in the third quarter or whatever. And just understanding that when you play that way, there's some mistakes and teams are going to make some shots. And like 10-point lead in this league is nothing. So kind of understanding that and then still trying to keep the pace up and get our run going. So I think we did a solid job as a team.
Since you've gotten here, obviously teams are, like you said, they're swarming you, they're top blocking you like as often as possible. How have you adapted your game, like, since you've been here, as the defenses have changed?
Yeah, you get used to, obviously didn't see that stuff earlier in my career, and it's just, I'm happy I get to experience that and kind of getting better as a player to make those reads. And so every night might be a little different, but you're kind of learning how to be efficient and how to impact the game, even if it's not me shooting the ball, but their top lock can still make an aggressive cut and get somebody else a shot. So just trying to find the ways to impact the game with that way, whatever the defensive coverage is. So.
Were you ever top locked in playing in Arizona or with the Finnish national team?
That's going way back. I don't know. Yeah. Probably not. No.
Yeah, I'm just curious because, like, you know, then that was, you know, when you were the best player on the team, right?
Yeah, I don't think I was.
It's also kind of like a newer thing teams are doing.
Yeah.
Okay, everyone good?
Yeah.
Thanks.
All right. I don't think so.